Whoops. Seems like I destroyed my browser and it killed the music. But it doesn't matter. We're almost good to go anyway, so I might as well just start talking. Welcome to everyone watching to the S5 Grand Finals. We got WinningRoad versus Hive Mind. And we will just be trying to get through with the checkup here and then we can already start. So the first map is Site 3, which is already promising to bring a lot of action right off the bat. Okay, seems like we're ready to go. Need to accelerate the checking here a bit. I guess I got that one already. Okay. So on Hive Mind, just to get the teams down in case you don't know yet, we got Contagious, Kame, Combi, Fire, and NeverDodge. And on WinningRoad, we got Silver, DancePuuh, Gaara, Nilo, and Egoku, who is actually Suwaku. Has requested a last minute roster change for his special account. And I'm ready to go, and so are we all, so then we will already be able to get into the match. Just 1 minute, don't worry, it will start in a second. Alright, we're going full screen here. On Site 3, DS5 Grand Finals are ready to go. Once the players have finished loading, we are ready to jump right into the action. And we got Contagious already grabbing the ball while he's getting shot at. He's jump up to escape with his minimum amount of HP left. Combi's getting pushed away by DancePuuh's counters sword, but they let Contagious run. And they pick the ball, don't let it reset, but Gaara falls down, resulting in reset either way. Fires picks up the ball and lets the sentry gun do the work for him while DancePuuh is trying to go for an anchor while NeverDodge stops him in mid-air. And Suwaku picking up the ball and trying for an anchor. Trying to go for an anchor but failed there. Kame is going for a lonely rush. Combi follows up. Silver tries to stop him with the dagger and he gets pushed away a lot, but that's not enough. Combi is scoring the first touchdown after accelerating past Silver, who kinda got surprised by him. Rushing up from behind. Great pickup there by Combi, making it all the way to the goalpost, extending their lead for Hive Mind already. Now Nelio is trying following up with a quick pickup there, but he dies before he can get too far. Kame is going for the pickup pretty fast, but WinningRoad is already cleaning up the field. Well, Contagious and Fire just going for a bit of action there. Actually, they're going for a reset now. Suwaku trying to go for anything, but Hive Mind stops him from doing anything fancy. Nelio tries to pick the ball, not really successful there, and Kame now has a pretty good chance for a pickup with NeverDodge and Combi following up and WinningRoad all respawning. Silver and Suwaku going in with the melee weapons, but Kame just rushes in the right second. No chance for WinningRoad to defend him there, great job. Just waiting a bit, dodging the melee weapons, not being too hasty with his actions, and yeah, scoring the second touchdown for his team. Alright, we've got a lot of deathmatch there in the middle right now. Nelo trying to save the ball with his anchor. Not sure if he can actually do something. But it seems like both teams killed each other equally. The ball carrier dies and the ball is reset. But it seems like WinningRoad kind of has the advantage now, as DancePuuh can pick up the ball and make it somewhere. But they took too long, so Hive Mind is already in the respawn. Puuh trying to reset, making up for anchor for Suwaku. Fire got him just in a right amount of time, so the ball would reset, so Fire can pick it up, and he's going for a long anchor. Silver trying to kill him. Fire's getting up there, jumping. Perfect jump. Oh, but the ball is stuck there. Combi getting the ball there, and he has enough SP to score the touchdown. Great job. Almost messed up the pickup there by the ball getting stuck into the wall, but there was still a spot where Kame could pick the ball, which he then did, and he was able to score the third touchdown. Only one more touchdown left for Hive Mind to end this first half before the time ends, and they're going for a quick reset here. Fire is going for the anchor, only DancePuuh and Subaku there. Oh, Fire slipped. No, he fell down. No chance for this, and now Hive Mind actually would be surprised if they'd be able to do anything right now. These small mistakes cost a lot of time. Subaku's taking the ball. And now the WinningRoad needs to step up and try to get something for themselves. Fire going for an anchor. Oh, this looks bad. Neluro only there to defend, but he gets shot by DancePuuh's handgun. Good job. Boss lying there, not resetting. Contagious is trying going for it. Combi picks up the ball again, and he goes for the PS dash, but Nelo gets him. He's stunned. His team tries to stop him, and he managed to score the fourth touchdown. Even though he was stunned all the duration with the backup of his team, he managed to survive and dash all the way through for the touchdown. Great job there. The ball wasn't really quite reset, even after the carrier died, and so his team could follow up, and WinningRoad quite didn't realize it, or at least weren't in a position to pick the ball, so they kind of had to try to set up for a defense, which didn't quite really work out. Hivemind managed to score four touchdowns in the first half, and that already looks pretty promising for them to win this first game. But obviously, WinningRoad now has a ridiculous amount of boost, which allows them to come back into the game. And now with the size change, we are going into the second half of this first match. Gaara already just rushing through there. Dodge trying to stop him, but seems like there's no stopping him. They want to close out this fast. They only have 10 minutes to score three more touchdowns, and Gaara just going for a solo rush there. While the rest of his team tries to kill all of Hive Mind, which they should have an easier time now that they are boost. Which again allows them to deal a ridiculous amount of damage, and the block carrier has more SP at his disposal to score. And Gaara again goes with the same method, just rushing in alone and leaving his team with the rest of the guys. And now WinningRoad closed up the touchdown count. They kind of have woken up from the first half there, but you should never be a team that you shouldn't, as a team, never even be able to wake up. Making up, building up momentum is already quite important, but with the boost in S4 League and not being able to not have it, even in team matches, that means even a losing team can easily come back from a touchdown disadvantage, as we just saw. Quick two touchdowns in about 1 minute. Ball is lying there. Hive Mind trying to get control back into the game. But again, WinningRoad showing superior map control here. DancePuuh trying to buy some more time. Ah, tried to anchor up, but they were just coming from all sides, no chance for him. Subaku going for an anchor, tries to go unnoticed, he's actually not killed. The Hive Mind tried to follow up, and Kame in the last second reacts with a follow-up with his own anchor. Otherwise he would have got an easy way to score the touchdown there, because nobody of WinningRoad was there. I mean, no, your Hive Mind was there, right? We're switching sides now. All is happening so fast, I can't really even comprehend what's happening here, but I'll obviously try my best. So I don't really know where the ball went. I guess nobody knew. Subaku just took the ball and juked the opponents by jumping up on the trains, ships, whatever we are here on side 3 anyways, and going for a quick plasma sword dash, I believe, which then allowed him to score another touchdown. trying to fool the characters here a bit. Right, got DancePuuh going for the anchor. Not sure what he's trying to do. But Contagious is ready to stop him together with Kame. But Dutch trying to take the last HP there. To get the ball into that position. Nice stun there with Subaku. Getting fire in mid anchor. Hive Mind now really has a problem to take back this game. They dominated so hard in the first half. Combi trying to get somewhere. Not sure how the pickups are going. WinningRoad concentrating now on also killing the followers and not only the ball carrier, which is really a more of a basic way to do things. Not only focus on the ball carrier, because easy pickups can make up for easy touchdowns. Now both teams trying to take a long way there, not risking anything. 5 minutes left on the clock and both teams are only one touchdown apart, with Hive Mind still leading since the first half. Oh no, Subaku saving up his SP to make with two anchors over there. Fires waiting and going in with the CS revenge, stopping Subaku in mid-dash. Great job there. Just waiting for the defense, not trying anything too fancy. He just waited down on the goalpost to jump up in the right moment to get Subaku in his dash. Great job there, and definitely the most efficient way to stop a PS dash from into the goalpost. And wow, Combi got unfortunately pushed out of the window by a random counter sword, stopping the offense by Hive Mind. Ah, that might have cost him valuable seconds. Nelu trying to go in with the CS. Ball is dropped and he picks it up as he jumps into the middle. Got stopped by Contagious. Now Fire tries to make something out of it by picking up the ball, but he has to defend himself with his counter sword. Ah, Kame tried to get the ball, but who did actually stop him there? Left him with not too much HP left. Oh, and Kame gets pushed around like a sandbag by Nelu's counter sword. Fire got the ball carrier, but Silver picks it, takes a lot of damage from the sentry gun though. As Fire follows him up and tries to immediately get the ball, Dance only left with his handgun decides to just run away and annoy someone else, and leaving the defense to Nelu and to respawning Gaara and Silver. Subaku coming in with the dash, but Kame now picks up the ball. That might be dangerous. Oh, he's just dashing through there. Good job there by Kame. Seeing an opening in that defense by Gaara and Silver and Nelu. Just rushing in there, using the cancels of the counter swords from WinningRoad to get a bit of extra dash there by doing two quick follow-up dashes. Kame going for the anchor, I guess? No. Just following down, Dodge trying to go for a quick anchor before he gets stopped, but didn't quite connect that. Now Dodge going for the bottom half. Kame is following up, picks up the ball. Great job there. Now only Gaara, no chance. Don't even need to say anything. Kame's just taking these three touchdowns. Well, that's what he says. WinningRoad seemingly no chance to stop Kame in his way. If he's getting the pickup, then he's most likely to score the touchdown. Great job there. Oh, Kame now going for it. Jumping up over the trailer into the goalpost. No chance, he's just too fast. WinningRoad was kind of distracted and Kame went for the wall jump on the middle pillar there to get up off on the trailer from behind and using the PS dash to get into WinningRoad's half, even though the bridge wasn't even destroyed, so he could just take his dear time. Subaku going for a quick anchor two below, and he might actually just be fast enough. Wow, good job there. Nice action here for the first game already. Subaku following up with a great anchor there, judging the situation right, and Hive Mind needing a second too long. They couldn't really do anything because he decided not to dash anything anywhere, which doesn't really make quite a lot of sense if you're coming from below. since you can't really reach the goalpost. And Fire going for the anchor, trying to close this game up here, and nobody of Winning Road is there. He just takes the touchdown and ends the first match with an 8-4 for Hive Mind. What an explosive offense game by Hivemind there, especially with Combi scoring 6 touchdowns there. Seems like that's kind of his favorite map, or at least WinningRoad's least favorite map, as they're just rushing through side 3, taking the first 4 touchdowns in the first half, ending the first half and putting the pressure on WinningRoad already. And even though WinningRoad was able to kind of come back, it seems like Hivemind didn't lose their momentum there and just picked right up where they left off in the first half to win this first match. And if you didn't know, the grand finals are just like the match for the first place, third place, I mean, is a best of 5, so we might as well take a bit more of time here. Doesn't mean that usually Hivemind would have taken this game in the next, if they won the next one, but no, they need to win 3 matches if they want to take these finals. And the prize money, which we actually have something of for the teams.
Thanks for your help!
Okay, everyone, we are back after a quick break, rechecking equipment. We are back on station 3. As far as I can see, only Hive Mind exchanged one member, and now Last is coming in. Seems like he's the guy that will be responsible for Hive Mind's win in this round. As you can already see, he first picked and made a good position for Contagious, as Combi picks up the ball after Contagious. Kame and Dodge trying to run it up, but no chance. This offense didn't do anything. Still, WinningRoad has to decide what they want to do. Kame kind of stopped them, and now Last is only there to defend. That might be quite critical if Gaara can score this one. Contagious picks up the ball after a quick dagger rush. Contagious tried to trust in his teammates to shoot open the wall, but it was a bit too late, so he didn't get anywhere. Maybe try to do a wall jump, who knows. Combi's dropping the ball as WinningRoad picks it up. Now he's there going for the other half with no defense there. That seems like an easy touchdown. Yeah, WinningRoad gets it. And that's what makes Station 3 so difficult and why it's so crucial to play in a team in this game, in this map. Because if you rush alone and try to score, the more you will be punished if you fail to score, because then the opponent team can just pick up the ball while your team is trying to follow you, and they can easily just jump over to your goalpost while nobody is defending. And that means, well, you kind of gave the opponents a free touchdown. So always try to advance as a team, and if you're going into the offense, try to make it at least last as long so your dead team members can respawn or score it all together. Now WinningRoad is trying to take a long way there, but resetting the ball after Combi kicked two of them down. Still, WinningRoad in ball possession, with Gaara trying to buy some time. I guess they were trying to reset. Anyways, they did so, and Subaku trying to go over the train. And right, doesn't seem like they're really getting far here. Trying to play it safe. Contagious gets the ball, drops it. Combi taking the jump panel, back into the middle. Oh, DancePuuh, good job there with the breaker, stopping him. Shouldn't have too much HP left. Kame with a quick pickup, trying to make room with his CS, going for a wall jump, but gets stopped by a violent revolver there in midair. Silver trying to run for it, saving the ball. Last kills him with the plasma sword, and now he's free to run. Gaara following up, but he doesn't get close enough now with the CS. Last is trying to make a last effort. Kame trying to stop Gaara. Gaara going for reset where Silver waits for the pickup as Contagious follows up, but isn't there in time. He can't get close with the melee, but Silver decides not to rush for it right away. Maybe because Last and NeverDodge were already respawning. Subaku kind of slipping there or resetting on purpose. I can't really say that from up here, but Gaara got the ball, so everything is fine for WinningRoad. And again resetting. WinningRoad going for these quick resets just to stay into ball possession, which is quite important. If you can't make the offense, you have always the option to reset so the opponent can't counter rush you. And now DancePuuh trying to get dangerously close to the ball, to the goalpost. Kame gets him with the CS, but he's still alive and he's handgun pushes. Still, Last got the ball out of this offense, and that means they are now in a pretty good spot. They're nearly going in with the PS. Still, ball to Hive Mind. Combi has the ball, going, trying for the wall jump. Ah, but he misses that. He kind of got stuck there. Now they have to take long way. Subaku trying to get him with the CS, but never dodging Contagious, cleaning up the room. While Combi is resetting the ball. Not sure if that was such a great idea, but maybe they decided they would just want to group up a bit. Last gets stopped by Silver's revolver. Maybe there was a good choice by Hivemind, not committing too far. As I said, the reset can still leave the ball in your possession. If you're feeling like you're not getting into the goalpost, you'd rather just reset to have the ball possession rather than giving the opponents the ball, because then it's awfully close to the touchdown already. DancePuuh still in the middle trying to catch all people with this breaker. And now Lass is getting under heavy fire there. Oh, both Contagious and NeverDodge missing the pickup there. That was a crucial mistake. Now Nelu just rushes for it alone as Kame lines up to try to stop him. And Gaara now wants to get for the quick pickup. Nelu going in with the PS dash. Oh, good job by Kame hitting both. Nelu and Gaara with the counter sword, so his teammates could pick the ball up. Otherwise, that might have been an easy touchdown for Winning Road. Danger, danger. What a nice chance, run. Danger, danger. And Hive Mind, no chance of getting through there. Even after that action, but Winning Road. Alright, so they tried to destroy the wall there, but they all four failed, so they all died. And now Hive Mind just needs to take the ball and go into the goalpost. They managed to do so, Winning Road with a horrible mistake there, by hoping that anyone would shoot the wall good enough so all of them could get over. Instead, they all fell into their death. Which you might have not known if you haven't played the game too long. Actually, these destructibles have a separate health bar for every player. That means even if you unload, if every player unloads a couple of shots, if one doesn't deplete his own health bar for the destructible, it doesn't get destroyed. And that's the kind of the thing that happened here. Everyone was shooting at it, so everyone was under the impression that it somewhat would die in time, but it didn't, because everyone just jumped there and stopped shooting, which resulted in all of them dying. Now Hive Mind just trying their own luck there with the jump as Last rushes over, jumps over, and trying to make room there. Last with the reload cancel, and whatever he was trying to do, that seemed like a mistake. He PS dashed into the jump panel, which then catapulted him off the advance and off his team just into the straight reset. Both teams not quite familiar with this map, or at least not as fluid, as there are still a few mistakes coming up. But the station 3, every second counts, so might be just be that a bit unlucky there. But Winning Road again opting for the reset, but Last gets him with the PS stun, quite fortunate there. And now he rushes in there, Silver with his revolver stopping, and Kame going for the pickup, but he misses it because the breaker kind of stopped him. And DancePuuh again too eager to jump over there, resetting the ball in the process. But still not a too bad position for Winning Road there, as all of the team are on the goalpost, and now only Combi set to defend. He's quite slow there. It's quite slow, but good job there by Kame. His CS finished all of them off. Last going for the jump panel, just taking his dear time, not making the same mistake as Winning Road there. But DancePuuh with this breaker stops all of them. Contagious dying, only NeverDodge and Combi left. NeverDodge maybe deciding to go back. So it's looked a bit on purpose, so just saying that was all his strategy. Wow, and you get Scar with the Jagger. He should be pretty low on health. Nelu trying to get him with the stun, but he couldn't care less with his 10 HP left at max. I don't think really matters. And there he goes down. Silver on the ball. Chance, run. One there's a bit more of deathmatch going on. Despite this map being so prone to quick touchdowns and severely punishing offenses, counter offenses, both teams only have one touchdown. But now Kame is trying to make that out. Wow, great job there. Kame just wall jumping in the right second after his handgun push to ensure that the breaker doesn't hit him, and he just hits the right spot there that he gets catapulted by his wall jump right into the goalpost. And that means Hive Mind will again win the first half in the advantage, even though it's not a 4-0. It's still one touchdown, and they have shown that they're less likely to make a mistake here on Station 3. That means this remains pretty exciting. Start. Show me S4. And we're already into the second half now. Come on, man. Last grabbing the ball and killing Neluro in the process with an interesting dash on the jump panel. Last dying pretty fast there, but NeverDodge picking up the ball, trying to juke there, Contagious going in to try to clear some room, but NeverDodge, oh, still has HP left. Unbelievable. Alright, seems like NeverDodge got in there with help by Contagious, just spamming their deer ray through Winning Road. Was a bit more of a lucky coincidence, but it looked good and it brought Hive Mind one touchdown closer to the end of the second match. But now Nilo is going for a hero run there, no one to defend him. This time Winning Road managed to just outkill Hive Mind and sending one of their rushers to just take the point they've earned. Winning Road not giving this up. Don't want to let Hive Mind get too far ahead, like the first round. Oh, last kind of choking there on this spot. Getting stuck. Now we see Hive Mind, Combi and Kame trying to make up some room there, fighting Winning Road. As Contagious is going to reset the ball, I didn't even quite know where he went. They just bought some time until someone for the pickup was there. Oh, Kame getting under heavy fire. Winning Road in ball possession now. But he dies really quickly. And NeverDodge now going for the jump panel. Last is shooting it open. Now we got Nelu there with the PS and DancePuuh with his breaker. Great choke point for them, especially for the breaker. Contagious and Kame trying to do something. Gaara and Neluro with the PS and the CS. Lasts there for the pickup in case Contagious dies, but he doesn't. Scoring the fourth touchdown now with a great juke there over the ledge on the side or the little ramp. Well, Winning Road already resorted to melee. Contagious took his time and saw his chances of being able to jump around a bit longer as nobody was shooting at him. He was able to score another touchdown for Hive Mind. Winning Road really needs to hurry up now. Can't fall behind like in the first match. DancePuuh and Tsubaku trying something to do there, but DancePuuh is jumping and resetting. The resets look better in the first half, not sure what Winning Road is trying to achieve with those. Nice. But we got a really strong offense right now. Tsubaku just rushing straight for the goalpost. Contagious trying to say something with the breaker, but no chance there. They're just all teamed up at the reset and then all rushed through there. And this was just this bit too fast for Hive Mind. They couldn't assemble for a defense there. once you're too close to the goal post, it's only back to it's you can only resort to random milling, trying to get something. But the breaker doesn't stun, only it kind of pushes you away, and they can actually be quite dangerous, especially in defense. And again, Nelu going for it, but he gets stopped in mid-dash. But DancePuuh for the pickup there. No reaction by Hive Mind on the pickup. WinningRoad scores the 4th touchdown, evening up the score count, and now they are actually back in the game. And it seems like they have a good chance to win. WinningRoad now playing a bit more stable, just going for these rushes. And Hive Mind doesn't really have an answer for that. We'll be seeing what they can succeed by continuing to rush. So, and Subaku again just going for the old counter sword combo trick, and I can't believe he got through with that. Just always taking his time, going for the CS combo, looking behind, seeing how far the enemies are away, and then turning around again, continuing his advance with the counter sword 1-2 combo, which is quite effective and flexible. You can mix it up as you want. Really strong technique, especially in sword only. It makes it also hard to predict, as if you were just running. And now we got dodge rushing. And Hive Mind on the offense. Kame just going for it. Silver tries to hit him with the revolver. Oh! Good job there by Kame. Silver was trying to get him with a revolver, but he wasn't able to get him. And in the last second, when Silver wanted to take out his dagger and hit him, Kame pulled out his CS and went for the revenge, stopping Silver from doing anything and allowing him to score. Both teams are really tight now, except that WinningRoad has a bit more score. That doesn't mean anything, just one touchdown, can close it up. And last, going for the perfect rush there, jumping on the pillar, going for the wall jump and a quick PS dash into the goalpost, showing that Last actually has knowledge of the map. That was the reason why Hive Mind took him in. And it's starting to pay off for them. Let's do it. Kame going for war jump. Seems like we got one disconnect on Silver. Run, run. So Combi is sitting for them, resuming this match in a 4-on-4. Last trying to buy some time, jumping out in the right second to avoid all the melees, but DancePuuh following up with the breaker. Now DancePuuh's trying to go for an offense, trying to go for a reload cancel, buying a bit of time, also trying around to jump, but now we're actually seeing Kame going for the wall jump on the wall. Great job there. Wow, that actually worked. It was kind of a gamble, but it worked out great because his teammates were shooting at his wall, right? So he was trying to do the wall jump, I guess, and if they destroyed the wall, then he would still not reset the wall because he would just get up there. Now that he got a wall jump, he was able to get to the goalpost even faster. So it's kind of a fail-safe way to make sure you get there no matter what you do. And if the teammates happen to react or know what he's planning, then he's even getting there faster. Now WinningRoad has to enter there, and Gaara tries to do so. Doesn't have enough HP left, so Last trying to go for the same thing. Ah, but he came in too low. No chance. Ball's not reset. That is an awkward position. I guess someone with Anchor could pick that up, but I guess it's not as safe. There's no real reason to pick Anchor here anyways. WinningRoad not stopping the offense, Last trying to stop Subaku, but that might actually be too late. Nope. WinningRoad securing the 6th touchdown, but Hive Mind only needs one more. One more touchdown and this is over. WinningRoad really needs to be careful, they can't do anything reckless here, even though there are only 2 minutes left on the clock. Bonus reset. Kame is picking up the ball, trying to run away from free winning road, and succeeds to do so. Winning road needs to kill. They can't lose too much time. If they got three people running after one guy, they will lose a lot of time and space. Last now trying to close it off. Oh, Gaara gets him with the revenge and also gets zNeverDodge. But Contagious picks up the ball. Gaara tries to go in. Contagious resetting the ball by getting pushed into laser. Unlucky there. Hive Mind no chance to get through there, but WinningRoad needs these defenses badly. But still, Hive Mind really have the option now of closing off the game or trying to play defensively. We're staying in the middle, but no, they're going all out. zNeverDodge trying to make some route, make some room. Gaara picks up the ball. Now that's his chance. 30 seconds left. They need to close up this match. Kame only there for the defense. Oh, he gets pushed. Gaara doesn't die by the Counter-Strike hit. That means WinningRoad closed it up, and there's only 15 seconds left on the clock. And WinningRoad should still have point advantage. That means that touchdown might actually have sealed it. But no, wait. I was mistaken. We got silver on the disconnect. And the point isn't quite right. I'm not sure how this is handled here, but we need to check that, I guess. I'm not too sure, because as far as I know, silver's points get added to that, right? Same as Combi's. So basically right now, Hive Mind has the point advantage, but due to disconnect, silver's points aren't shown. Anyways, however, this match will end off. Great job there by both teams, staying head on head. Okay, so basically we can check that later, but since we kind of know that in the second half, we got WinningRoad in the point advantage. It shouldn't be surprising that WinningRoad actually got this. Damn it. Just getting quick back in the room. Okay.
So,
can I clear that up yet with the points? As both teams are kind of aware of, WinningRoad has actually won the second round here, so it's now 1-2-1 for both teams. Now on station one, we will double check that later, but. For now, we just continue with the grand finals. Okay, and we're ready to start for the third match on station one. Both teams now have one win, and we need to go up to three for one team to take this grand final. And Hive Mind already going in there with a quick rush. Combi picking up the ball after getting pretty far. But seems like we got a disconnect already on WinningRoad. Doesn't matter.
Danger, danger.
Noisy now. Taking the ball out of their pit. WinningRoad already dangerously close to scoring a touchdown.
Danger, danger.
Combi gets stopped by his CS, dropping the ball right. After right in front of the sentry gun. WinningRoad going for a quick reset when Nilo's ready to pick the ball up. No sentry gun set up by Hive Mind. That actually. Wow! Subaku trying to pick up the ball. Ah! Too late! The follow up is not fast enough. And now Contagious going for a quick counter attack. Again, Subaku not making it in time. Both teams with the same strategy. Resetting the ball after the offense of the opponent, but WinningRoad gets it first. They managed to score this first point here on Station 1. And Hive Mind secured the ball there. Combi going for double wall jump. Ringworld not really paying attention to the ball after they killed the ball carrier. Great job. Combi taking his advantage in rushing his skills. Seems like he's just as good on Station 1 as he was on Site 3. But WinningRoad is going to answer that. Silva cleared out the way together with Nilu, and now Gaara trying to go over there. Nilu picks up the ball, Contagious not hitting the CS. Noisy Soul and Combi already for the defense. Contagious picks up the ball and doesn't die to the breaker. That means WinningRoad's attack is now over. If Contagious dies, now Kame has a quick pickup, and Gaara actually tries to kill him with the sentry gun, but we got already defense coming in, stopping Kame and the others from Hive Mind from advancing further. Now Gaara just gets in there, almost got pushed into the goalpost. Silva now tries to save the ball. No, actually he's in the enemy half, so he can just score. Just kinda getting mixed stuff up here. These offenses are so fast, kinda hard to keep track on. But WinningRoad making a quick comeback. Kame trying to go into for a double wall jump and manages despite getting pushed by the sentry gun. Wow. All these unexpected rushes actually kind of succeed there. Kame just went for a double wall jump despite knowing he got pushed by the sentry gun and even shot at. He got the CS jump strike onto the ledge to the goalpost and just needed to score afterwards. Subaku tries to get a ball somewhere, but Contagious and Kame standing strong there with the dagger and counter sword, defending the pick. Nelu rushing in, picking up the ball. Sentry gun in the way, gets just destroyed. And Subaku rushing for it. Ball lies now there. Silva not getting the pickup, but managed to pick it up afterwards, and now we got only Combi in the defense. Silva, not any SP left, will go for a reload cancel. Combi gets him in there, and Gaara not able to go past Kame. Now WinningRoad, no, Hive Mind will go for a reset, but WinningRoad takes it. That might be a bit dangerous, but Hive Mind stopped them right on the corner. Subaku for the pickup, Noisy trying to deal some damage with the breaker. Subaku just taking the bridge for the goalpost. Hive Mind kinda making a mistake there by standing on one spot trying to defend the ball after their false reset. And that was the chance for WinningRoad to score a touchdown. A quick reset there might have been a mistake, but Hive Mind still not giving up on their defense. Silva tried to sneak in the quick touchdown after a kind of faulty reset by staying too close to the laser after defending. But Kami now tries to bring in, gets killed by the sentry gun. Noisy just gets handed through by the melees. DancePuuh not really able to go anywhere. Hive Mind takes the ball. Everybody, let's go. And Nilu going for the real cancer. Contagious stops him with the counter sword. Very strong there. safe in the last second there. Can't really complain, that was pretty good. Hive Mind now trying to go, make something out of it. But Kame dropping the ball right into Gaara's hands. Who then just starts to rush. Silva, wow, juking the counter sort of contagious. Ball's dropped, trying to get a pickup there by WinningRoad, but no luck. Hive Mind has this under control for now. Kame. Just bringing the ball. Wow, DancePuuh was able to pick the ball from above. Just a neat little trick. When you bend the ball down there, you have the chance of picking up from above if it's high enough. Hive Mind not opting for a reset. WinningRoad has the upper hand here in the middle with setup sentry gun. DancePuuh rushing for it. Ah, got Tsubaku, but he got destroyed in midair. Hive Mind back on the advance. Contagious dropping the ball, not resetting it. Combi for the pickup. He's not sure what to do. Tries to wait a bit so he doesn't get stopped. Oh, Noisy with a dangerous pickup there. Nilo only there to defend. The sentry gun will shoot at him, but it's not enough. Noisy gets this pickup in the last second there. Great job by stopping him in midair with the breaker and immediately killing him. And then taking the ball, not getting flustered by Nilo. Managing to score the fourth touchdown. Ending this first half a bit before the time runs out. That means Hive Mind has taken control of the match one again. Both teams really preaching a similar playstyle here on Station 1. Both teams have a sentry gun set up for defense and mid control. Both teams have good rushing capabilities, but it seems like Hive Mind just a little bit more successful. But that does have to be that way. Is what DancePuuh says. He goes for a reload cancer, doesn't quite make it up there. And Gaara's attempts to follow up were a bit. Too fast. WinningRoad going for the reset there. DancePuuh picking up. Sentry gun is getting set up. Ooh, WinningRoad may have no chance on that offense. Oh, Combi for the reload cancel. Oh, Contagious trying to go for the pickup, but Gaara and the sentry gun make up for the defense. No, WinningRoad tries to go for a counterattack, but Kame really stops them with the great two hit from the counter sword. And now Silva was trying to go for the goalpost here, but he got instead pushed, got pushed all over the place, landing everywhere except under to the goalpost. And reset by WinningRoad once again. And Hive Mind still respawning. Nah, that's too late. Great job there by WinningRoad. Just taking these dangerous rushes by Hive Mind and dismantling them and using them for their own rushes as they all just wait in the middle. And again, WinningRoad kinda trying to force their way in there, but that doesn't really work on Station 1. There's too many melees there. If you're not in the majority, you really have a tough time, unless you get lucky. Nelu, Gaara and DancePuuh going full offensive here. Oh! Dangerous mistake there. He decided to dodge, to dash into laser or something. I'm not really quite sure what that was. Kame trying it on his own. Neluro going for the bridge, making sure that Kame can't score a quick touchdown. What? Wow. Kame going for the handgun push, allowing his team members to easily follow up and pick the ball up as WinningRoad doesn't really manage to get the pickup before that. Oh, Nilu. Will he get it? Not really. Again, dangerous situation. Hive Mind just, most of the time, get really lucky there. Let's go, go, go. Oh no! Come on, man! WinningRoad. This time on Gaara. Oh, gets killed in midair. That was actually kinda difficult. But DancePuuh this time getting it, using the wall jump to get over there. Are you ready? Start. Show me your S4. Chua, Karengoya. Warning, go to your goal post. The guy's getting mirrored all over the place. Nice. Danger, danger. Too much action in the middle. Combi trying, but he's alone. Can only buy some time for his team. Warning. Go to your goal post. Ball gets dropped in the middle. Nelu picks it up. All right now. And Puuh rushing for it. Wow, great job with the handgun push there. Ah, Contagious not going for the reset. But Gaara and Silva just destroying them with the submachine guns. And Neluro just trying to... Does he have enough SP for a wall jump? No, he doesn't. But Gaara there for a quick pickup. That might have been a mistake. Hive Mind killed him in time, but... DancePuuh and Subaku for the follow-up. WinningRoad manages to force Hive Mind into the defensive and just... building a line of pressures, never stopping the offense, and Hive Mind has no chance of getting out of their own half. Supercar dropped the ball conveniently. DancePuuh getting pushed around by too much CS. That was a bit dangerous. He would have had enough SP for a wall jump, but he wasn't fast enough. Noisy going for a quick handgun push. And scoring that. Always wondering where WinningRoad comes up for defense, but sometimes they're just in respawn and there's no chance for them to do something. Hive Mind again taking the lead. WinningRoad can't relax yet, even though they have kind of taken the momentum into their favor. And Gaara going together with DancePuuh, but both die at the same time. Not making it possible for a pickup. Noisy going for a handgun push. Kinda fooling them there. Combi waiting for a pickup. Silva spots him. And Combi has no chance to pick the ball. They're just keeping him in delay. Got Hive Mind on the offense. Ah, noisy, unfortunate reset. Couldn't cancel the rush with this, the pushback with this breaker. But still, Hivemind takes ball control. Oh, it was a mistake. They killed Fire too early. Oh, Contagious doesn't know what to do with the ball. Was kind of surprised that he got the ball. But he has enough HP to score anyways. Good job there. Contagious kind of making it a second too late, but that was actually in his favor because WinningRoad thought they were safe, but he just rushed past all of them, picked up the ball, and now quickly used the last remaining SP for a wall jump up there, and actually managing to score the touchdown. Oh, that's match point for Hive Mind. Only need to score one last touchdown. Hive Mind only need to focus now on keeping the ball in their possession. DancePuuh tried to kill him, but not getting there. Noisy now, kind of rushing it as fast as possible. The safest place for the ball to be in is most likely the enemy pit, because they have to need SP to get out of there efficiently, and that will cost them a lot of time. Now Hivemind trying to get the ball away from their DancePuuh, just rushing for it, but doesn't have enough SP, HP to get around the corner. Hivemind obviously not going for a reset now. They don't need to. They just try to stick together and kill WinningRoad one after another. Oh, but Nelu's getting dangerously close. DancePuuh. Ah, he got pushed. Still enough SP left, but no HP. Subaku going for the pickup, but even he gets killed in time, and Gaara makes it just a second too late. Ah, that looks bad for WinningRoad. As time is running out, Hivemind is going for the last reset of this game. Noisy picks the ball up, making sure WinningRoad doesn't even get another touchdown. And he's just going for it. And that means Hivemind won the third match now, leading 2-1 in this whole set of the Grand Finals. Okay, we are already back to the fourth map already. On the grand finals, WinningRoad versus Hive Mind. Hive Mind leading with one match, so that means if they win this one, they actually win the grand finals. And the fourth map, we got Wonderland. We'll see what both teams will do here. I saw already that this map is actually pretty cool for basic competitive games, because well, it offers a lot of rushing options, but at the same time also is very open, so it enables people to shoot a lot. So it basically just comes down to who is the overall better team at both rushing and shooting, as there are not too much room for shenanigans. Just needs a good coordination from the team, making sure the pickups work and that the defenses work. Otherwise, well, there's not really many other ways to win on this map. Right now we're only seeing a bit of deathmatch here by both teams. Nothing too far. Winning or trying to bring the ball somewhere, but Hive Mind returns it. Mostly scattering out there. Hive Mind securing a quick point lead. But nothing too fancy. Just get the round started. Last going for a war jump. Maybe trying to jump out of the around the jump panel. Kame going, but no. WinningRoad's defense of melee weapons was just too strong. No chance for Hive Mind to get through, but it was already pretty close. And the counterattack also is really close. And we got the new member from WinningRoad who joined them, KingLiban, scoring the first touchdown on this map. Going for a great pickup and then a quick PS dash. Plasma Sword definitely the better weapon here for rushing, as you need the bit of distance in the last open area around the goalpost. WinningRoad need to win this one to have another chance at winning the grand finals, so they need to go all out. But Hive Mind obviously now has a chance to win this. They will try just as hard to get this match under their control. Kame just taking all the way to the other side, making sure he's free enough to score the touchdown. And it's looking bad, man. Just succeeding. Kame going for the option of going all the way to the other side while WinningRoad was still respawning and the others can't defend. And while he dies, last picks up the ball and takes the first touchdown for his team. Gaara now resetting the ball after getting pushed back. Fire trying to rush for it, but King getting it in the end while getting pushed back. Not that big much of a deal. Kame going for it, taking a lot of damage, last following up. Might be a chance, but he get pushed back and he has no HP left. He can't cancel the knockback. He will reset the ball, and now Nelu trying to buy a bit of time, not rushing in there, just ducking and taking cover. Even though in S4 there are just only a few options where you can actually use ducking for actually getting cover. But it's quite neat in a few situations, at least in theory. Hive Mind got the ball out of that situation, but immediately resetting. And now King's on the ball. He's going straight up, again ducking, waiting for his team.
Warning, go to your goalpost. Warning, go to your goalpost.
Slowly, Hive Mind making an advance. Kame not ready to reset the ball yet. Wow, NeverDodge gets the ball handed to him. But WinningRoad takes the control here. Just being too stable. Last falling down. Silver following up. Kame getting the pick. And Gaara intercepting. Kame trying to take the way up the bridge. Let's do it. Warning, go to your goal post. And NeverDodge just rushing for it. Ah, last trying to get for the pickup, and he gets it in the end. Oh, Hivemind managed to snag up the ball from WinningRoad. Kame now going for it. The last rush combi. Wow, great job. But WinningRoad just too organized here. Hivemind following up with four consecutive pickups. But WinningRoad was just in a better position there. Ball's getting reset real quick. Now Hivemind again with four people on the advance. That's dangerous for WinningRoad. Last trying to go for it. They need to reset the ball now. Last falls behind by a bit. Fire still enough SP for a war jump, but he gets stopped in midair. Ball is lying there. Gaara gets a pickup. He needs to defend now. Ball drops onto the goalpost, where Silver gets it and uses the jump panel to get out of there. That was really, really close. WinningRoad can't afford to get these close rushes so close to the goalpost. Actually, the ball getting thrown onto the goalpost pillar. Oh, last getting pushed quite dangerously in there. That was a mistake. Last took that chance, saying thank you to WinningRoad for being able to getting pushed so close to the goalpost, using the remaining SP to get into PS dash range, just taking that touchdown for his team. 3 minutes left. Let's go, go, go! King dropping the ball right in the middle. As WinningRoad fighting for the control. Dance rushing it. Combi stopping him. Which now goes on the offensive together with Last. Kame picks up the ball, but King gets him with the PS. Kame trying to reset. I'm not sure if that was, well, it didn't really make much of a difference. WinningRoad would have most likely reset anyways. Now WinningRoad together with Dance, Gaara and Nilu and Silver following up. But unfortunately the ball carrier gets pushed away, stopping the offense immaturely. You need to take care if you have the ball that you're not in a position to get pushed away too far or even get the ball reset, because that sets your team behind. You're not able to rush properly. It's like in Station 2 when you're on long way. Don't just get into a position where you reset the ball because all your team was stuck on long way. But last now. Ah, ball resetting. Silver gets it. Last and Kame not trying to do something. Ah, Dance Breaker not strong enough. Last again gets another touchdown. Just by being able to rush all the way up by himself. And in the end, Breaker didn't deal enough damage to kill him. But Nelu wants to close out. Wow. I didn't even know who really rushed there. But Nelu gets a touchdown after getting pushed right into the goalpost. He didn't even need to try. Crucial mistake by Hivemind, pushing him right into the goalpost. They can't afford at this point to lose any points, even though they have taken the lead and are still in lead. Just one touchdown and that can turn everything around. But the first half will end like this. Hive Mind with 3 touchdowns, WinningRoad with 2 touchdowns. Show me your S4. Right in the second half now. Danger, danger. That's getting the first pick. Hive Mind not able to capitalize on that offense. As King picks up the ball right after last dice. Now WinningRoad approaching with 4 people. King gets pushed away, but not far enough, but Kame gets him finally, dropping the ball onto the bitch. Nedu getting pushed, but again, due to these dual pushes in the air, WinningRoad still in a good position, but after they all died, Hive Mind takes this. But again, Hive Mind taking too long to defend these offenses, not sure if WinningRoad won't be able to capitalize soon. And again, WinningRoad going from the left side. NeverDodge securing the ball. Now we can see Hive Mind assembling on their left side. Last again. Wow! Good teamwork there by Hive Mind. Combi clearing out the way with the counter sword, while Last saving up his SP for a quick wall jump. Hive Mind showing superior tactics here. Just saying, we got this game. Everything's going as planned. It's really almost kind of lacking an idea here how to win this game. But still, they're not out quite yet. Still got plenty of time to make this up. They certainly got the capability to do so. Warning. Go to your goalpost. Last again, opting for something. But Gaara gets him. Takes the jump pedal, but kind of messes up. Resets the ball instead. Kame goes for it and runs straight to the same place. Now backing up a bit, trying to make a bit of room. Last not making it in time. Gaara gets a pickup. Kame was kind of getting hesitant there and went too far. Let's do it. Dance not being able to pull off any fancy tricks. Kame actually getting up there. Oh, that's a mistake. He can't never be let, but he decides to jump down by himself, as nobody was able to follow him. Usually it's quite dangerous if you get up the bridge, that's why it's easily destructible. Dangerous! Defense! Defense! Nice chance! Danger! Danger. Oh, Kame with a dangerous pickup again, but falls down. What a nice by the push. Both teams are a bit disconnected right now. Don't really have the chance to go together. And there's a lot of deathmatch going on. Wow. They all together they stop King from trying anything. They really don't want WinningRoad to score another touchdown. Which you can understand. They have the advantage and Combi again going for these for the counter sword engages while Kame was waiting already, but Combi died too fast and now they don't really have a chance. And that was actually kind of funny. As Hive Mind got kicked back, they all got onto the jump panel. So WinningRoad could pick up the ball, and now they have a pretty good chance. Nelu forcing his way all the way through, gets killed on the goalpost, but managed to score anyways. And that's the kind of breakout WinningRoad needed. They needed a touchdown. They needed to make sure that they're still able to score. And now they need to score some more. Okay. Run. Drop. Dangerous. And still, they're not really going together. Dangerous. Defense. Just trying to bring the ball somewhere. It's getting kind of intense for Hive Mind now. They know they really haven't been any successful offenses in the last few minutes, and WinningRoad slowly coming back into momentum, and there's still 5 minutes left to play for WinningRoad to score. What Hive Mind now needs is another touchdown, or WinningRoad really is in a good position here, despite being behind in points. The momentum clearly speaks for them, and Dance now has an open goalpost, and he can't die. No. WinningRoad is taking over this match. This will get really difficult now for Hive Mind. We'll see the point count in a minute, and even that is not too far ahead. Actually, WinningRoad takes the advantage now. So Hive Mind needs to follow up. They kind of fell asleep in the last half, and they can't afford to do that, even though they were an advantage in touchdowns. It's now 4-4, and WinningRoad is 20 points advantage. And now, Hive Mind is together, Fire is trying to go up, drops the ball, Kame picks up the ball, King missing the stun. Kame just trying to force his way in, but he falls away, too far away. Combi trying to get the ball, but now WinningRoad has an equal good chance. Last and Fire there for defense, WinningRoad trying to force its way through now. Oh, Last, not quite hitting the stun there, Nelu trying to make some get some room there in there. Kame forces him to die. Combi for the pickup, and now they really need this touchdown. 3 minutes left to play. Combi trying to stay alive until someone can follow up. Oh, Kame went for the pickup, but King was faster, reacted, didn't want to let him have that ball. Last and Dance missed the opportunity to pick the ball in time. Instead, they wasted too much. Last taking the pickup from Kame, trying again to stay alive. NeverDodge is following up, but decides to reset. That was a mistake. They weren't going. They weren't going for a pickup, make a room for a pickup for Kame. But Dance was already in the way. Silva not going for the reset there. Instead, trying to stay alive as long as possible. Now King is on the ball. Fire defends him. Gaara still going in there with this CS, and now Last and Combi have a chance to score. It's all up to Silva now, but he doesn't hit the counter sword. Great counter attack by Hive Mind, going with the two-man offense by Last and Combi, the two arguably strongest rushers in Hive Mind, currently putting up a great performance for their team, and again taking the lead. And now WinningRoad is back on the spot. Hive Mind has proven that they have not fallen asleep and scored another touchdown. Now WinningRoad needs to follow up there. And they only have 1 minute left. It gets more and more intense here, seeing as Hive Mind can win this. Now, Kame going for a super quick reset. Not sure if that was intended, as Silva gets the ball now. And now they are going on a four-man offense. Oh man, Dodge now really needs to try to defend them, but he only has a dagger. Silva trying to not make any hasty moves. Kame tries to get them with the CS. That is really dangerous. WinningRoad is still alive, but Kame managed to make some breathing room for his team, giving him time to respawn. Now Gaara's going unnoticed there, dodge hitting him with a couple of revos, and he needs to get this ball away now. Wow, great job, last second of defense there by NeverDodge, hitting enough with the revolver to be able to pick up the ball. Kame now in ball possession, King trying to get it, but now WinningRoad is stuck into respawn while Hive Mind is together, and they try to DM in the safest spot possible on the lower half, which requires WinningRoad to run the maximum amount of way of distance. And now there are only 20 seconds left to play, but they are already back into the base of Hive Mind. But they get pushed away. Only 10 seconds left. And Dodge has the ball. WinningRoad has no chance to do anything here. It actually seems like Hive Mind is going to take this. And they do. Great job by WinningRoad, trying to force this game back into their favor. Actually managing to close up the game so close. And so back to a 4-4, but Hivemind in the end got it. They're scoring last touchdown to stop them from breaking under the pressure. And just holding out the remaining minutes to the end. And that means Hivemind wins 3-1. And with that the grand finals. Got WinningRoad on second place and Kamen on the third place, which has been played last week. And that pretty much concludes this season. Hope you guys enjoyed watching it.